They work their way back onto the field. And from this spot in the field, with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he finds his tight end, Graham. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. We have hit halftime. Still two more.
We now
proceed to the start of the second half.
Man. Let's go here. No, I can't quit.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the six. They find some open field here. Oh, nice move in midfield.
We all know the teams never want to use the word panic.
Okay. Alright, and exit game. Go ahead and switch your linebackers out there. Might do one more challenges. Didn't win, got knocked out. Just don't know football. We got destroyed. That's probably also true. That's right.
Charles and I settled here in the booth.
That's
this should be
a 16-5
ultimate team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it.
Mm-hmm. Don't rush him.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Yeah, I do. It's probably not going to work.
The offense readies for a first down and 10.
Series, who's going to gain an advantage? But we saw exactly what happened there. A tone was definitely set by the offensive team.
And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27.
Maybe win this one. That feels nice. Probably going to be a 4-3.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
There's that chemistry thing again.
The keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and 8 and 9.
They give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football. They'll try to run for it with Miller, and he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
It's like a computer. I don't think I can sit back on the line.
A first down carry now for Miller. They'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Something they saw a lot in 2015, and the fewest rushing yards of any team in the NFL.
As one of those dubious titles that no one really wants to claim, even teams who say, well, I don't worry about running it because we throw it all the time. Being able to run it when you is a key to success in the NFL, and Detroit struggled doing that.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
And yeah, frozen.
15 he goes. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
And effective running here. They'll take it down inside the 10. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Too much money on the line.
Again, it's Tomlinson. And he will maneuver his way down about the 7. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
To throw to Stafford. Now that'll be tempted and intercepted. Cut off with great anticipation, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Yeah, I mean, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right. I mean, overload.
On the run, this is Jackson. And he'll get him a little space here up to the 5-yard line.
Forgot.
Overload.
Give
him 4 yards there. Overload
to pass play on the play.
They give him a lot of credit there, but even more credit to the guys up front. In that situation, you know it's going to be a stacked defensive front. And to be able to gain that much yardage, that's a big win for the guys on offense.
Yeah, they were just about standing on their own goal line, so they get a few yards there. A great start. Now we'll see what second down brings. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. 8 yards there, getting him out of danger. It's a first down. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down.
Give me Sanders.